But he will paint them as
you.
Un-American as well. That's what we saw last night.
And I'm sorry to interrupt you, but we're hearing from Senator Lindsey Graham on Capitol Hill right now. I want to play that.
Well, you know, I think y'all need to ask her, do you still think we should impeach the MF? You know, as a Republican, why don't you go talk to these people about their rhetoric some, too? She's just introduced legislation, Omar has, that will destroy the state of Israel by boycott, compared them to Nazi Germany and the Soviet Union. What you don't get is that I don't have any animosity toward anybody who disagrees with me based on their origin. The point is, they're all American citizens entitled to their voice. And when they do provocative things, they're going to be met with provocation. So this is a two-way street, not a one-way street. I'm trying to fix a broken immigration
system. But what message does this send to other naturalized American citizens that a predominantly white crowd is chanting, send her back?
Here's what I think. I think the president is playing on the 1968 love it or leave it. I've said before that if you're a Somali refugee wearing a MAGA hat, he doesn't want to send you back. You probably have dinner at the White House. What does that tell me? That it's about the criticism and the critic, that the president believes that what they're doing is over the top. We're not running concentration camps. So when you start accusing people of running concentration camps who work for the United States government, you're going to be met with some pretty fiery responses. I don't like it. I'm not going around telling anybody to leave the country who's an American citizen. To a naturalized citizen, this is your home as much as mine.
Isn't it racist, though, to say send her back?
No, I don't think it's racist to say. Was it racist to say love it or leave it? I don't think a Somali refugee embracing Trump would not have been asked to go back. If you're a racist, you want everybody from Somalia to go back because they're black or they're Muslim. That's not what this is about to me. What this is about to me is that these four congressmen in their own way have been incredibly provocative. The first moment she was, you know, introduced to the Congress, Tlaib said, we should impeach the MF. And
does the president have a responsibility to be above this as the leader of the free world?
I wish he would talk about the policies and not the personality.
It's been a racist trope for the two of
if you think he's a racist, that's up to you. I don't.
No, but it's been a racist trope for some time to say go back to your country, even though you're even if you're an American.
I think he said go back and come back and tell us how to do it.
But they were saying send her back.
My point of view is I'm not saying send her back. I'm saying as to President Trump, the bottom line is that if you embrace his policies, it doesn't matter where you come from, he probably likes you.
This discussion yesterday, though, isn't it the responsibility of government, of you as elected leaders of our country, to tell the American people that these kind of comments are inappropriate?
I think they are. I've said that like 100 times, aim higher. This is not helpful. This is not kind of response that's going to lead to solutions. I think it's very appropriate you ask them some questions, too. Most Republicans believe that this is a one-sided debate, that you give them a complete pass on their incendiary rhetoric. And, you know, pretty much there's a cultural war going on in this country between people who believe in socialism versus people who believe in traditional freedom, and you see it playing out.
How much do you think this has changed? I mean,
okay,
John
you
McCain,
have been listening to Senator Lindsey Graham, an ally of the president's, chair of the Judiciary Committee. I want to quickly get back to Congressman Jolly, and I apologize for interrupting you, but we wanted to hear what Senator Graham had to say. What do you make of it?
Hallie, that's a terrible moment.